Maximum Baci. Excellencies, dear colleagues, ladies and gentlemen, it is a real pleasure for me to host, I guess, the first welcoming concert this year, although I will still have to excuse myself in front of my two colleagues in a way, because I offered to do this a bit earlier and then I had some issues with one important tool to have a concert, which was the piano, but now we're all up and running. And I take it that you have all been longing for this opportunity, and that's why you're here so plentiful. Also, I want to thank, of course, the Societatea, really, for upholding this wonderful tradition, a unique tradition, I have to say, of welcoming concert. We all feel very, very special when we get this treatment. Of course, also thanking the sponsors for helping us out today. I hope you're all comfortable. We will have the concert, but first I do want to invite State Secretary Nicolescu to say some words, also on behalf of the Muzicală industry. Thank you.
Please make sure that you switch off your mobile.
Yes.
Please double check.
So, Excellencies, new friends, first of all, Happy New Year for you all and for your loved ones. May it be with health, prosperity, peace, of course, and yes, you excellent relations among our countries. Thank you to the Swedish ambassador, dear colleagues, for bringing us together this evening, and of course, Georgia for also bringing us together to these concerts. They are welcoming concerts, and this time we have two colleagues from Europe, Madame Helene van Haften from the Netherlands and Massimo Baci from Switzerland. Welcome to you both to Romania. We are so glad to have you here, and we are sure that you will appreciate Romania. There are many of your colleagues here can tell you how beautiful and interesting Romania is. And if they are not convincing enough, you can always count on the Ministry of Foreign Affairs. We are very persuasive. And since I'm speaking on behalf of the Ministry of Foreign Affairs, I would like to thank your countries for their support for Romania for joining the Schengen area. You can see how much it matters for Romania, but also for European countries, and I should say for the European spirit. Talking about accessions, thank you also for your support for our accession to the OECD. It is a Romania top priority, and it's also a file I'm dealing with at the Ministry of Foreign Affairs. So I should say that I have a personal interest in this accession. But we are not here for most speeches, we are here for listening to good music and to know better each other. So thank you very much again, and once again, welcome to you.
Thank you.
suite for flute and piano by one of the most important Romanian women composers, Carmen Petra Basacopol. And since in a few days, on the 15th of January, we will celebrate the national culture of Romania, the day of national culture of Romania. So I thought that it's a good occasion to present you this piece. Since also Carmen Petra Basacopol died last year at 97 years old. The piece is inspired by Romanian folklore traditions and is in five parts, and one of the parts are songs of love or songs of joy. So enjoy.
Thank you.
be a trio. So, who is Luca? I think he will I will talk about a little bit about the next piece. Deux ans de lutte by Jacques Ibert, one of the French composers that wrote a lot for flute. So he also wrote this little trio for flute, violin, and piano, or harp. But since we don't have a harp, we have to learn on piano. So the piece was also incidental music for play, which is considered one of the version, the feminist version of Don Juan. So it's the story, a feminist version of a woman who is like the seducer. And the piece has a very strong French Iberic atmosphere. So I'll let you discover it.
Thank you. discovered a beautiful soprano, which I performed last year in Bucharest in Exato. It's a piece by a French composer, Rinaldo Hahn. It's a lead, actually, for voice and piano, which I loved it, and I did an arrangement only for piano. So this version of Acloïs, this is the name of the lead by Rinaldo Hahn, I will perform tonight. It's a very romantic piece.
Special opera house in Bucharest. First piece I'm going to present to you is Ballad by Ciprian Borobescu. Ciprian Borobescu was one of the most famous early Romanian composer, and still is quite famous. Actually, last year was the Ciprian Borobescu cultural year. And this is really, really very, very famous piece. I mean, it's his hit. Let's say it like that. Okay, that's your.
Thank you.
then back. Balshem was a rabbi, a Ukrainian rabbi, if I'm not mistaken, who founded the Jewish Hasidic movement. And this nigun has a really strong religious value. Last piece of the program.
Beautiful.
Story in the last 10 years after his welcoming concert, so then I thought, okay, I should not try to compete with my predecessor. He's a wonderful man. He may continue to hold the trophy of the best speech after a welcome concert also for the next 10 years. I won't try to do anything better than that. But it is a bit difficult, yeah, to say something personal. I don't really know how, where should I start. Maybe I should start by saying that it's actually wonderful to have this concert in this beautiful place, which we'll get back to that later also, because it is a little bit, it feels a little bit, and that's also why I'm very happy that we could do it now, Therese, really, and not before, because it is the end now of the beginning. This is how it feels. I came in August, and my first 100 days are over. In our system, they always ask you to write some notes after the first 100 days, so I did that just before Christmas. Then there was a bit of a Christmas lull, so to say, but then it wasn't, because there was lots of family and very little vacation. So this marks very much the end of that first beginning. And it's also a very nice time because I'll have a real vacation in the next 2 weeks, so that's also really great. I'll have a nice vacation in my home country. And maybe I should tell you a little bit about that, because that's also nice, because I'm representing the Kingdom of the Netherlands, and you may or may not know, but the Kingdom of the Netherlands is not only this rainy bit of Western Europe where it's quite cold and everybody has wet feet at the moment, but the kingdom also has a part in the Caribbean. So I'm actually going on a home holiday in the Caribbean, and that's really nice. And I've never been to the Caribbean part of the kingdom, so it'll be my first time. And I tried to convince my boss that it was actually a fact-finding mission. Fly into that in January, he said, "Well, it's a good vacation, you have to pay for it yourself." So. I don't know what else you would like to know about me. Maybe I can add a little bit of flavor by telling you the story of how I came to Romania, because that's a nice story also. It involves a lot of Romania. It's also actually a good story because it involves a lot of diplomatic friendship and a bit of a love story and also a bit of European integration. So I'll tell that story. That should be good, because I think we all need a bit more love and European integration and diplomatic friendship in these difficult days, so I think that's I'll do that. So how did I get to Romania? It's actually a nice story. It starts in the middle of the 1980s, actually, when a young British diplomat was having his first posting here in Romania, and it was not a very easy time for him. But after he finished, he went on a second posting as the first British exchange diplomat in Germany. And that was, at the time, Germany wasn't unified, so the foreign ministry was in Bonn, and this British diplomat was the first exchange British diplomat in Bonn. And he worked there for, I think, about a year or something like that, and he met with a very young, at the time, German young diplomat, whose name is Götz Lingenthal, and they became very good friends. So that was very nice. That was the first bit of European friendship there. And they both grew up and became a nice gentleman. And much, much later, the German diplomat had been divorced by then. He was appointed to become the German ambassador in Algeria. This was about 2012, so he went to Algeria. And then shortly after that, the British diplomat was also appointed to be the British ambassador in Algeria. So these two old friends who had remained in contact, they met again in Algeria. And a few months after this happened, yours truly was appointed the Dutch ambassador in Algeria. So I met with these two old friends, one Brit, one German, and we actually became very good friends, all three of us, in Algeria, until the moment where I became a little bit better friends with the German diplomat, and then even more better friends with the German diplomat. And of course, the British diplomat being the British diplomat, he found out immediately, he gave it away very badly. But it all ended with the fact that Guts and me are now married. Unfortunately, he couldn't be here tonight because he's in his native Germany. And the story doesn't end there, because Andrew Noble, who's the British diplomat, was then, after he left Algeria, reappointed to Romania as the British ambassador to Romania. And Guts and me were in Berlin at the time. And at one point we said to each other, we should go and visit our friend Andrew in Romania, because neither of us two had ever been to Romania. So we said, okay, let's do that. Let's make a nice road trip. We like road trips. Let's make a nice road trip to Romania. So we took the car and we came from Berlin and we traveled through Slovakia and then Hungary, and then we arrived in Romania. We did a big round tour, about 3 weeks through Romania to visit Andrew. And at some point in Maramures, I think it was, I said to Guts, wow, this is a really nice country. You should really come back here. So maybe I should apply for a posting in Romania. And Guts was supportive of that. And so that's how we ended up in the end in me applying and then getting the job and then us arriving in Romania. Well, that is that is maybe what I should share tonight. I wanted also to say a few thank yous, but maybe, Massimo, you want to share a bit about yourself first, and then we do the thank yous after that.
Precious to me as a newcomer. Fortunately, my ministry, they didn't task me to write anything after 100 days because I, according to my experience, after 30 years of diplomatic service, I have the impression that my apprenticeship usually lasts for 4 years, and at the end of my apprenticeship, it's time to go. So, anyhow, I'm particularly happy to share this moment with you. It was a little bit in the air that eventually we could do something with Sweden, right? Because Switzerland, Sweden, you know, we are almost the same country. Yeah, many of us, many maybe not in this room, but many mixed up Switzerland and Sweden, right? And not that much as Swaziland, but to some extent. There is, by the way, they changed the name to 18, so the problem has been solved. Swaziland, but we have the issue, right? And I think that also contributed to entertain the confusion. You know, we share major multinational companies like ABB, Brown Boveri. The owner of IKEA was living in Switzerland for a very long time and traveling second class in Swiss trains. Traveling second class in Swiss trains. What a lesson of humility. Absolutely. absolutely unbelievable. And also, we share the same skepticism for the use of euro, right? And we were both neutral countries now. You went a step forward and we remain a little bit backwards. But we contributed to entertain this confusion, right? But in fact, we are two different countries, right? You have Volvo, we don't tell anything like that. We have good skiers, but not to be compared. You have ABBA, we don't have anything like that. Well, we have George Clooney for Nespresso, but it's not really to be compared, right? We used to have Federer, but now he retired. So really, I think that no, we cannot compete really. Maybe on one thing we can, though, because yes, you have hearings and you have meatballs at IBS, but we have Swiss chocolate. And some cheese also. So I think on that we do have something to by the way, I'm sure that probably none of you knows that Switzerland export more coffee than cheese plus chocolate together. And that Switzerland is the second largest exporter of coffee in the world after Brazil. Thank you, George Clooney. Okay. So yes, we also have a national. Thank you so much for this.
And some Swiss chocolates too, I think. I wanted to grab this opportunity to actually say thank you very much, first of all, also on your behalf, Therese, for organizing this.
Swiss watch sister company of Rolex.
Yes.
It all comes together. Yes.
It all comes together. And I wanted to ask George to come back in because I actually have something to give to him, which is in the orange bag, and I'll give you the orange bag with it. But I wanted to thank you also for being the driving force behind of this, and for organizing us this concert, and for having me over the orange bag at the right moment.
Your next holiday.
Is this in Dutch? This is, it should be in English.
I'll try to keep it.
Thank you so much. And like Emil already said, tying it all together, we do have some Swiss wine and some Dutch cheese and some additional pieces over there. But really, thank you for contributing also to the culinary experience. Thanks for your patience. I hope you enjoyed it. Really, it was the most remarkable. Such strong performances. Really, really impressive. Thanks again.